Hey everyone, how y'all doing? Welcome back to the Movement Kids with me, your favorite teacher. And by the way, do you know what season this is? Yes, that's right, it's Christmas and we get to decorate a Christmas tree with, you know, sprinkle and stuff, you know. And what's more cool, we get to watch cool Bible stories and let's enjoy the show.
Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose, and have come to worship him." And behold, the star went before them until it came to rest over the place where the child was. And when they saw the star, they were overjoyed. And on coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him.
Silent night, holy night.
Hello kids, I hope you guys are ready for worshiping God today. Please prepare your heart, sit still, and let's sing the song, "God, You Are So Good." Thank you, Lord, for such an amazing day. Now, we're going to listen for your word. Please bless the word and help us to sit still. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen.
Amen.
Stories of the Bible. Creation. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was empty, formless, and dark. But the Spirit of God was there. On the first day, God said, "Let there be light." And God saw that the light was good. Then he separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day and the darkness night. On the second day, God said, let there be a space to separate the waters of the heavens from the waters of the earth. God called the space sky. On the third day, God said, let the waters beneath the sky flow together into one place, so dry ground may appear. God called the dry ground land, and the waters seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let the land sprout with every sort of plant and tree. And God saw that it was good. On the fourth day, God said, let lights appear in the sky to separate the day from the night. God made two great lights, the sun for the day and the moon for the night. He also made the stars. God set these lights in the sky to light the earth, and God saw that it was good. On the fifth day, God said, let the waters swarm with fish and other life. Let the skies be filled with birds of every kind. And God saw that it was good. On the sixth day, God said, let the earth make every sort of animal. God made all sorts of wild animals, livestock and small animals, each able to have babies of the same kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make man in our image, to be like us. So God created man in his own image. He formed man from the dust of the ground. He breathed the breath of life into man, and a man became alive. Then he saw that the man needed a helper, so God put man into a deep sleep, and while he slept, God took one of the man's ribs. Then God made a woman from the rib and brought her to the man.
Hello.
Hi.
Then God blessed them and said, be fruitful and multiply. Fill the earth and rule over it. Rule over the fish in the sea.
Hello, Will.
The birds in the sky.
Hello, bird.
And all the animals that scurry along the ground. Then God said, look, I have given you every plant throughout the earth and all the fruit trees for your food. And I have given you every green plant as food for all the animals. Then God looked over all he had made, and he saw that it was very good. So the creation of the heavens and the earth and everything in them was done. So on the seventh day, God rested from all his work. And God blessed the seventh day and said it was holy.
Wow, how cool was that Bible story, kids? Did you know that that's how the earth was formed? I love that they said that God made us in his image. That means you and me, we look like God. We act like God. We're made to be like God. But see, not all of our friends still know about God. So it's our job to show them what God is like by being like him and acting like Jesus did in the Bible. Now, I know it's kind of hard to understand, so we're gonna do a bit of a demonstration here, all right? So I've got my cookies, and since it's Christmas, we're gonna decorate these cookies. My challenge is I have to try to draw my face onto this cookie with icing. Sounds easy? No, it's really not, but I'm gonna make it even harder. I'm going to be blindfolded the first time, all right? Should be fun. Okay, I've got my cookie and I'm going to draw myself. Alright, you guys are gonna get to see it before I do. Does it look like me? Let's see. Not too bad. I got the eyes and a little bit of a smile. But let's see how much easier this is when I can see myself. So I've got a mirror, and I'm gonna take the blindfold off. Ooh, can't forget my Christmas hat. All right, now I'm going to make myself. Like my twin. What do you think? Twins? I think so. See, kids, it was so much easier to know what I look like when not only I could see myself in the mirror, but I could see what I was drawing. And it's just like that for all of our friends and family who don't know what Jesus looks like. Not everyone has read the Bible or been to Sunday school or been to church, so nobody has taught them what Jesus is like. So it's our job to show them how Jesus is loved. And one way we can do this is by being kind to our friends, by helping them when they seem to be struggling and need some help, or doing something nice just out of random. You know, you might see your mom looks a bit sad, you might do something nice for her. And just remember that if it's something that Jesus can do for you, we can do it for other people. That's what we have to remember, guys. Remember that Jesus loves you and is always going to forgive you and will always be there for you. And it's our job to show people that we can be like that too. All right? Easy enough? Just don't forget that it's our job to be like God, because we are made in God's image from the very beginning of time. Now, before we get going, let's go to our Bible verse for today. So today's Bible verse is in Genesis. It's Genesis chapter 1, verse 26, and says, "Then God said, let us make human beings in our image to be like us." One more time, Genesis 1, 26 says, "Then God said, let us make human beings in our image to be like us." There we go, kids. Just a good reminder that God made us to be just like Him, so we can show everyone Jesus' love. Now, before we get going, let's quickly pray. Lord God, thank you so much for today. Thank you so much for creating this beautiful earth and creating us in your image, Lord God, for giving us the ability to love just like you love us. I pray that you would just remind us to show that love to other people, to teach all of our friends and family the wonderful gifts that you have given us already, Lord. I thank you so much that you protect our family and protect our friends and help us to have a great day. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. All right, kids, I'll see you guys next time. Merry Christmas. Happy holidays. I hope you get the best presents from Santa. See you guys later. Bye.